Yeah. Lil Brunson back at you with the back at you, and I am the best reporting on the Eagles, man. So listen, man, the NFL and Players Union, they agree to financial terms. You know what I'm saying? It looks like football is going to start on time, and that's something to be very optimistic about. We all know of some of the key things that they took away. The players actually voted on this one. No preseason, you know, to help prevent the spread of infection due to COVID-19. But that makes sense. Come on, man. We're not going to risk preseason just so we can, you know, get infections and then the season don't start at all. So I'm very optimistic that there will be a season. But, you know, the NFL gets about, from what I was reading, I think they get about 25% of their $15 billion annual revenue from ticket sales and sponsors and stuff like that. That's a small price to pay. You know what I mean? That's a small price to pay. You can either have 100% loss or gain 75% of what you was going to get. You know what I mean? If things were to normal. So, you know what I mean? I agree with the season moving forward. You know what I mean? The Philadelphia Eagles. Now, this does hurt. This does hurt for, you know, guys that's ready for preseason. It hurts for guys who need to put tape out. It hurts for guys who are not going to make rosters. I think the union should have also put in place, I think they should have probably raised the salary cap a little bit and have each team keep an additional 5 guys. You know what I mean? Have each team keep an additional 5 guys for this year due to the mitigating circumstances, because you never know what's going to happen. And people and teams are really going to be just basing undrafted free agents off of college tape. They're not going to get preseason tape on these guys. You're going to have to, yes, when untimely injuries arrive, you're going to have to judge these guys off of college tape, which makes not that much sense to me. You know what I mean? I mean, it's the only thing you could do. So it's not about if it making sense or not. You got to judge guys off college tape. For instance, if Adrian Killens doesn't make the roster and, you know, he's out there as a free agent, somebody wants to pick him up, they just got to judge what he can do. And this is an example. They got to judge what he can do based upon what he's done in college. You know what I mean? And if preseason were to come around and he was able to play and show you some things, he might have showed you that, you know, he also could catch. He might have showed you that he can pick up blitzes very well. You know what I mean? He might have showed you that he has more to his game than what you saw in college. You know what I mean? So preseason is damn sure important, man. I know a lot of people like to not put stock in preseason. Some of us football fans who have just been spoiled over the years, oh, well, it's just preseason. Preseason tells you a story that needs to be told as well. Because if a team blows out another team in preseason, yes, it was mostly backups that's doing it and guys that's not starting. But if some of these backups are standing out like this, helping you to blow out other backups, then they deserve to be, you know, starters in most cases. Or they have a skill set of a starter, but it's just somebody that much better than them in the position that they're in on that team. So, you know, football starting on time is huge. You know, a guy like me who talks about football for the majority of my week, you know, as a hobby, you know what I mean? I think football starting on time is just a refresher that we all need, especially guys on YouTube and especially guys who just live their day-to-day lives knowing that football is something that they can lean on. We're still working on my end. You know what I'm saying? We're working on the small things, man. We're working on getting the studio ramped up. We're working on more appearances on the show. And we're working on more things in the realm of, you know, film breakdown. My last two videos prior to this one, we looked at some film and we gave our thoughts on those things. And I think growth and just maturing is just something that we got to keep doing in this thing of YouTube, man. You know what I mean? Shout out to everybody that's been copping the merch. I'm sorry for my late upload yesterday. I actually went fishing, you know what I'm saying, with the fam. Took some time to wind down, you know what I mean? The day-to-day grind can be grueling, you know what I'm saying? But like I said, football is coming back, and it's time to start focusing on what we have to do to pick apart the Washington Redskins week one. So it's not really about nobody else. We did a lot of Cowboys talk. We did a lot of Carson Wentzworth, Dak Prescott. That was real popular this summer, but we play them dudes twice a year. Now it's time to focus on the debacle that is the Washington Redskins. The Washington Redskins don't even know who their quarterback is going to be. Realistically, this is something to think about. If Alex Smith has been cleared for injury, which they say he has been, who should be playing? Alex Smith had them boys in first place in the division in 2018 up until he got hurt. Let's not forget about that. Daniel Haskins, Dwayne Haskins is still a guy who everybody is hoping that could be, you know, as good as Alex Smith. Alex Smith is a good quarterback. Alex Smith almost automatically becomes the second best quarterback in the division if he's 100%. He's been cleared for football contact, man. Those are the, you know, those words rattle me different because I know how I felt when Carson Wentz was cleared for football contact. Alex Smith is a good quarterback. You know what I'm saying? He's a good quarterback. Haskins might be sitting back. Haskins throws a beautiful ball, but Alex Smith don't turn the ball over. And you know what I mean? Alex Smith at 100% is something that would worry me more than Dwayne Haskins, talking from an Eagles fan perspective. You know what I mean? Talking about your defense having to, you know what I'm saying, go after Alex Smith or go after Dwayne Haskins. You know what I mean? I'm picking Dwayne Haskins. I am. Although Dwayne Haskins isn't very athletic, at the same time, he can run faster than Alex Smith. You know what I mean? He can do things. He's more athletic than Alex Smith. I'll put it that way. So, you know what I mean? It's time to start focusing on our week one matchup simply because the NFL is starting on time, and that's just a blessing in disguise, man. Let me know what y'all think in the comments.